Hey, Max, and welcome to the 24th episode of Bioshock Infinite Burial at Sea Part 2. Okay, it's not actually... That happened last time, too. It still scared me. It's not the 24th episode of the second part of the DLC. It's the 24th episode of the series, where you just happen to be on the DLC.
Hey, dude,
I believe we're...
Come on in and watch this.
Because I believe we're actually near the end. In the last episode, we finally got all the gear. Oh. What are you doing? I bet since you're all so cleverly not looking at me. Got 3-1. It's a dude. That's something I'll never get over in this game. How they just leave people's bodies everywhere. They don't loot them. They don't steal their clothes and burn it. Or anything. They just leave them. And then I knock people out, and they still don't even care. It's like, hey, Belle, doesn't this seem suspicious to you? And they're like, no.
Come here, hon. Got a sweet idea for you.
Why does it stay perfectly still? Works. Oh, sweet. Actually stays on, too. Oh, yes.
We're not finished.
Man, this is like the best power ever. If I had this in the main game, I would never kill anyone. I would just run around.
You're not getting out of it.
Jesus.
Bam! Suck. What a great power. This is so cool. Okay, so me being more awake than I was last night, I'll admit it. Something I kind of mentally realized is they did mention that in the first game that Fontaine was put down by Ryan. And then he like mysteriously came back and no one knows how, so I bet all you guys were seeing that before. It was something that I was kind of seeing last night, but now just like me casually thinking about it, it's kind of like, oh snap, that's actually where they were going with this. Anyway, I don't even know where I'm going. It's like, I don't even know. Where's the Big Daddy? You know the Big Daddy's right here. Wait, hold on. Blue thing! I want the blue thing! The lights of something! I really hope they can- If they can come in after me in the vents...
Let's test your metal!
Holy crap. Holy crap, this is how Max dies.
How can you rationalize power?
Is that a nail gun? Oh, wait. Oh, he has a crossbow, too. Alright, I think we're good. Wait. Well, I would love some frothy coffee. Okay,
whereabouts
so.
Of the foreign bitch scientist unknown.
Oh.
Ryan presumes she's dead, but our guess is she's gone underground with the little sisters.
Oh, that must be the one lady
on
who
obtaining the ace are dwindling.
That must be the one lady who crap. I can't. Ah, oh man, the thing's in here, and I can't get it. That's so. It looks like an espresso machine every time you look at it. But I think her name's Tenenbaum.
Ain't nothing been right for this time since Frank Fontaine died.
Well, okay, this is actually a pretty bad scenario.
Don't expect.
I gotta find some way to sneak up. Gotcha! Okay, let's take an evaluation of the situation. There's a Big Daddy. There's a bunch of dudes. I don't remember where I'm supposed to go.
No matter.
Okay, where am I going again? Oh. Final Man Winters, I already did that. And repair the Lutece device. I know this is the main room area. So. I have to keep doing that because I'm like scared that I'm not gonna pay attention. They're gonna kill me. Yeah, this is where this guy on the guitar was. I remember this guy. And he left his banana. Now I left that guy alone because I was like, ah, man, look at him. He's just singing his song and having lunch. I don't want to bother him. Okay, so, let's see if we can hit this. Because I very politely pushed the button. So, I think the lab's down here. He's like, I think the lab's down here.
I know real well how he's biased. I get into their heads. They never.
Why? Okay, something I've always wondered. And I wondered this in the first game, too. Bam! Is why it always seems like all the splicers. That's worrying. Why all the splicers are like failed stars. Because you know those other ones that are like child star. Child star! I think I actually chose the right area. I'm impressed by my own brilliance. Man, there's like no way I'm working on this. Great, what am I gonna do? I could start freezing them all. I only got a few shots. Oh wait, hold on, do I got a... No, oops, not that one. Okay, I got a few green shots and a few gas shots.
You wanna mind control everybody?
Take this and go.
You in the bedroom?
Like, I don't know how many people that actually got over there. But if I do this.
I see what you've done here.
I don't know how many people I knocked out there, but it's at least one. It's like I at least got one person. Oh, I guess that ringing doorbell and then that gas bomb was nothing, I guess. Alright, so let's see how many of those still are. Wow, I actually... No way, seriously? I took the... Okay, there's one. There's one girl up there. I bet she's supposed to be like real stealthy or something, right? So let's get her. Yeah, I just took down like three separate people, so... Ah. It's like... Alright, oh. How are we... Did I do this one? Oh, no, I already did that one. I got a bunch of Eve. Oh, yeah, this is the where I got the Peeping Tom, and, that's, yeah, I already did that. So I went the complete wrong way. This is like, where am I supposed to go? I get at least one shot for emergencies. At least one. What was I talking about earlier? I don't remember. I still love how this game is stealth-based. I think I've fanboyed about that every single episode of the DLC, but I love how it's stealth-based. And I know I had the option not to have it stealth-based, but... See, these games always have, like, this slight moral system, but not quite. Oh, there's a big dad. Who's still my favorite character. Like, no dialogue or anything, but you're still my favorite. Alright, so... Oh, yeah, so I still lose. Yeah, but they're always like... Oh, yeah, I was talking about how the splicers always are, like, yelling at each other. They're, like, always ignorant and arrogant and yelling at everyone. I'm just like, guys, why? Okay, so there's one guy over there. Oh, there's another guy over there. I'm gonna have to beat him a good one. I don't even remember where I was just gonna go. I guess I'll speed up till I get back to her. What's that up there? Yeah. Gotta. Oh! Like, that guy's just staring at me, and like, yeah, I was actually sitting back and going, wait, did he turn invisible? Can other people turn invisible? Oh my goodness, this is the worst thing in the. Oh! There he is. He's like, that was actually going through my head. I don't have enough. I'm missing one lockpick. If I could just get one more, I will go back and get that. Oh, hey, look. There's one more. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, let's go back and get that. Really, though? I thought the Big Daddy would attack. Well, okay, yeah, that's right. The Big Daddy doesn't actually attack people unless it has a reason to. And, like, 90% of the time, it doesn't, really. There we go. That's what I liked about the big daddies too, is like everything will attack you just for looking at you. But the big daddies will never attack you unless they're like, hey, you try to kill me.
Hypnotize
or,
big daddy.
Coming next year.
Oh, of course.
Gotcha. Oh wait, hold on. I didn't even notice it there. Cause they forget the player once they thought. Well, that's cool. That's not at least the way I use it. Hypnotize big daddy, coming next year. Hang on. Hang on, okay, so correct me if I'm wrong. Crap. I wonder if you'll. Oh, wait, here.
I won't hurt anybody if I don't have to.
So if big daddies are meant to protect little sisters, because, you know, the company said, hey, people seem to be kidnapping little sisters to turn them into slugs to take their atom, what the crap, guys? Then don't you think they would, like, not want to sell something that says, hey, remember those one things that was, like, the protection for the little sisters? Let's make a plasmid, and even if it's really expensive, let's make it so you can hypnotize our one important asset that costs a lot of money and takes a lot of time and energy and is very valuable and worth their weight in gold. Why would you do that?
Here, you may fulfill your potential.
No, we all...
I heard that.
No, you didn't. I heard that. Shut up. I know you're in there. No, 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 you don't. Shut up.
Okay.
This is rubbish. Alright, hang on. Let me speed up until I can find where to go, because I thought I knew where to go. I guess not. Wait, oh, there it is. There's the Silver Fin restaurant, so I just gotta figure out a way to get in there. That should probably knock that guy out. Since the Yankees come. Top.
You're against the guy making an honest
simple. You want to mind control everybody?
So I gotta like find
public
a way.
Address system. That's how you do it, Kara.
What you
just
do
like
to
that.
My friend, you do to me.
So I gotta find some way to go over there, and I really, really don't want to like do something stupid. But I'm gonna have to do it anyway.
We're not finished.
Well, well, what was that?
Think about it. What do they want?
Right now, like everyone.
What do they got to
come on, lady. Oh, Christ, man, I'm prepped for my next meeting.
I don't think it's in there, but yeah, the silver.
I ain't through with you yet.
I'm not gonna be able to snipe him. Because there's someone sneaking up behind me.
I saw where you went. Break's over. Back to the office.
Yeah, like I don't get their speech patterns. There's a guy like right there.
Because I'd like nothing more than to be Miss Rapture in 1958.
Okay. Yeah, like the girl, the mom's always talking about either like they treat you like you're their child. Crap, in the water.
Come here, hon. Got a sweet idea for you.
But they either talk like the girls always talk like they're trying to be beauty pageants or actors or models or whatever. Out of here, guys. The men always talk like they're failed actors or businessmen or something. It's very just creepy and disturbing.
Nope.
Yeah, they always talk like salesmen and stuff. I think the idea is supposed to be that they were like they like got so obsessed with their imperfections that they. Yeah, this is that they got so obsessed with their imperfections that they, like, sacrificed their humanity to get more plasmids to try to fix that. But at the same time, I can't help but get really confused by it. Wait, what's that? Like beans or coffee? Well, I mean, I need it, but I don't, like, need it. Really hope I can find something. That's my ticket. The greatest genius of alright, invisibility.
I know you're better than you know yourself.
Alright, yeah. They're all freaking out about me. I'm just like, yeah, whatever. It's great. Hey, man, I got my one shot. I can fix this thing. It'll be easy. Alright, so first step. I suggest we pull the power. And then we remove the crowbar. Insert CO2 scrubber. That was easy.
I have CO2 poisoning the moment we turn the thing on.
Why does this thing make CO2 again? I forget. I don't even remember how I was supposed to put this thing together. Where was this camera for the first time? Oh, there we go. Okay, so I jump up there and I jump up here. I need my stuff, see? Alright, so, I don't know what this stuff is, but I'm gonna grab it. Also, wasn't there a
problem? Big
chest?
Daddy will not imprint on the little brats. Yet Fink succeeded in imprinting his disgusting bird on his subject. How has Fink, the stupid man, succeeded where Suchong failed? If Suchong could obtain hair sample of Fink's subject, Suchong could determine delta of genetic material with little sister. Proof is in DNA pudding.
Oh, I get it. So they swap notes on how to make like a big... Oh, I thought I had lockpicks. Oh no, I have seven, I have $10, not lockpicks. So they got the songbird to imprint on me as Elizabeth. And he was like, how am I gonna get the big daddies to imprint on? They figured it out with smell. Cause I remember it's like, you like smell a certain way or something. We're just gonna leave the crowbar in there, I guess. I'm down with this. I'm down with this. It adds to it, you know. Yeah, look, there's me. Oh, like I'm not gonna have a flashback by seeing myself. All right. Okay, here we go.
Well, not the perfect phosphor frequency, but it'll do.
Nah, good enough, I guess. Now, I think they said the last part was like up there. Okay. Hey, bugger. What? Hey, bugger. Tell me where. Oh wait, no. The last step was Mr. Freeze. Doink.
Okay, that should stop it from overheating.
He's like, yeah, just a quick freeze. That should do
Everything's fixed. We're ready.
I don't even know what we're ready for. Really? Are you sure we don't need to remove that crowbar? Yeah, it's totally legit. As long as it's legit.
What did I tell you?
Open. Enter terror. Enter terror. Yeah, we've only been going for 20 minutes, you're fine. Columbia, never thought I'd come back to let alone to that exact moment. That exact moment where I wear the floofy dress. I like my floofy dress. Give me my floofy dress back. Just worn by Our Lady.
Look.
Check it out.
I'm the First Lady.
Switch. Retrieve the quantum switch. I probably look conspicuous. Yeah, whatever.
Can't be this easy. The First Lady Mark II was built around a particle lift system, just like all the buildings in the city. I read all about it in the Columbian Scientific. The particle seated at the top of the structure must be up that lift.
Really, I like how her thought process goes. It's really cool. And apparently pushing this button has told me this. Give me my dress.
Like technology just to float an airship. Comstock never heard of hydrogen.
The First Lady Mark I did run on hydrogen. And it was destroyed by a single bullet from a Vox sniper.
Oh,
unfortunately, the Prophet wasn't on board at the time.
Yeah, hydrogen balloons are really cool, but that is an issue. Alright, so they said I had to go up this lift. Then I should just have to, mess with that thing. Let's go see, like, a bunch of
if I take the active particle, then the First Lady is just a 40-ton paperweight. Best to take the spare.
I'll take the active! Why not? Oh,
let's head back
thank goodness.
You honestly expect Atlas to honor his side of the deal?
No, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it.
I can't believe how easy this is. Like, seriously.
How do you plan on handling Atlas? He ain't just some spliced up maniac.
Yeah, he's an intelligent spliced up maniac.
I just have to be ready to take advantage of it when it happens.
I'll just turn invisible then shoot him.
Know.
How well did you know me when you came to Columbia?
Oh, wait, hold on. Was that movement and me going up and down? Did that count?
Nothing but trouble that way. Best to head straight back to Rapture.
Hang on. There's the control room. And I see a box there! I want the box! So nothing but trouble that way. No! Now, I don't remember, like, the ship crashing.
Pretty lady not finished yet.
What?
Call, open the okay.
Tear. Power for devices, very expensive. Eat for that?
Just tell me what you want.
Suchong, you stop.
Suchong wants something as simple. Lock of hair.
Oh.
Not your hair, stupid. Think how you want secret me? Life.
I want to allow Big Daddy's to happen. Wow.
In there.
He's like, what am I cause?
In jar. Cannot miss it. You get for Suchong. Then everybody friends.
Where is his lab?
Close the office. Wow. Past Fink's quarters. And you smart lady, you find.
Yo, the fact that you don't speak good English kind of irritates me. I'm going to be honest. Max, that's terrible. How could you say such a thing? It bothers me, okay? I'll be honest. I really hope I'm not like...
We must have arrived right in the middle of the siege.
That means the other UN...
Call Songbird!
What happened if I did call
Songbird? And what happens if we run into ourselves?
We won't.
How do you know that?
Because we did.
Well, maybe future changes. Iron sights.
Prep to generate a bullet-snatching shield that places ammo into your gun.
Well, that sounds like the best thing in the world. That sounds exactly like Return to Sender when it was fully upgraded. Except for the fact that, I'm sorry to tell you this, I don't have a gun! I don't have a gun! What am I supposed to do? Is that something like way in the distance over there that I saw? Yeah, there's. I don't have a gun, guys! Well. Right. Oh. Who's like, well. Great, what am I supposed to do now? Yeah. Office of Jeremiah Fink. Wow, this is easy.
You've done good service, but I will not hurt the boy. I will see Fink and Comstock burn, but I will not hold the son to account for the deeds of his father.
You've misunderstood us.
What?
We neither asked you to harm the child.
Nor did we promise that yours would be the hand that would set Comstock's world afire.
She was stabbing children in the first one. Oh, she was about to. No way, she had a gun. I stabbed her.
A famous man once said.
And a famous man shall say.
I may reach the mountaintop.
But I fear I shall never visit the valley below.
But you mean I won't live to see the... No.
It's up to you what matters more.
Your part in the play.
Or the play itself.
Someone is coming.
She'll arrive, a girl.
She must leave, a woman.
And what makes the difference between a girl and a woman?
Blood.
Your part in the play.
Or the play itself.
Turn her into a killer? How?
Give the girl no choice.
And she will be forced to make one.
The Tuces? The Tuces? Lettuce people? Why? Why would you do this to me? Hey, don't mind me, Mr. Fink. Don't mind me, Mr. Fink. Hey, excuse me, do you know where the jar of hair is? It's like, excuse me, sir. I'm speaking to you. You can help me escape. Oh, I'm not helping you escape. I just need to steal from you for someone from another dimension. It's like, wait, you need to do what? I need to steal from you to get something from another dimension. It's very important. I think this is a girl. Oh, yeah, that's a girl. Oh, hey, it's actually a body. A good thing I can still steal random crap. I don't know where I'm supposed to go, but I saw, like, loot from there. Oh, wait. Hold on. Oh, I got no lock. Hoarders and explorers.
Say it!
Long live Daisy Fitzroy. Long live the Vox Populi.
I'm so stealthy, guys. What, like those people are gonna stop me from freeing them? I thought that was like an attack or something. Why would those people stay here? I don't know.
You can't hide forever.
Oh, dude, that guy was shot. But dude, people just died. I'm not here.
Who done this? Someone about?
I like your accent, by the way. It's adorable. Now, I don't want to shoot you, so... Wait until you turn around. Oh, wow, you're coming, like, direct. Wow, okay. Dude, she's on my case. Bow! That lady was so on my case. Alright, now, where is Fink's office? I'm gonna say it's... this way, question? This area is very calm, despite being in a war zone, so... let's see if we can just knock everyone in the area out, and then do something. Oh. Wait, hold on.
Who are you?
What's going on?
Oh. I don't know.
I'll find that piggy!
First off, why are there only girls?
Who did this?
Yeah, first off, why are there only girls? And secondly, why are the Vox talking about their crazy? The Vox were totally sane. I remember this thing. This thing gave me tons of stuff, and wow, I called it. They also gave me tons of stuff. This thing saved my life since this area was a complete and total war zone that just kicked my butt around town. Speaking of which... there's something over there. No. Not like terribly long, but not a short enough amount of time to actually remember this kind of stuff. Like exactly. Ooh, maybe I can use that next. Oh, no, it's the vent I came from. Oh, wait, there we go, alright. Isn't making any progress, guys, the crap, guys. Look, I'm trying to find civilization, and I don't know where to go. Is that it? Maybe this is it. I don't even know if this is it. I'm just gonna run around. Dude, one of your people just committed suicide. Like, holy crap. Oh. Dude, two of your people just actually saw it. He's like, two of your people just committed suicide. Okay, so I don't know if this is actually Fink's office, but using normal video game logic, why was a guard holding jewelry? Why? The loot makes no sense. You know what I should be getting? Machine gun ammo. Just be like, why do I have this machine gun ammo? And they'd be like, I don't know. And I'd be like, exactly, I don't know either. Alright, let's see what this is. Three voxophone.
What's the price you're willing to pay so that others may live free from the yoke? The wit knew the price and paid it willingly. And I sense what the Lutece twins will one day ask of me. So far, their council has served me well. Served the revolution well. If a bullet takes me, so be it. But to offer myself up as a lamb? When I come to my Garden of Gethsemane, will I play my role willingly? Or will I burn the place down to the roots?
Because I remember her yelling, like, before, saying, like, we gotta pull this problem up from the roots, and I was actually yelling back at her, going, no, why would you do this? You don't play. I actually think I said the exact same the words of, I will not blame the son for the father's misdoing. Just like, hey! Do I got a lock? Man, I still don't have it! Where is it? I saw it earlier. I know I did.
Little Piggy!
Oh, shut up. Is that it? I just need a lockpick, and I'm just too stupid?
That's enough of that.
Alright, so I guess I'm gonna loot these guys. I guess I'm just gonna
kill
them.
Something's going on!
Here I come!
Alright, so I guess they're both gonna cross each other's paths. Yeah, about here. So when they cross, I gotta drop down a little more and take them out. There you go. Alright, Ashley. Alright. I need to get a lock. Maybe I just need to get enough money. Alright. Oh well, I guess I'll just have to keep spinning me revolver thing, don't you know? I think I turned Irish and then started to turn something else. Alright, there we go. So I got myself a lockpick now. Hopefully that is what I needed. I'm just stupid. Alright, there we go. Over here. These locks are very conveniently the exact same. There's like no one in the area, so it doesn't really matter. That's it. Yeah, but she actually did that on purpose? It seemed like everyone in her rev- Oh wait, hold on, this is the main- Dang it! It seemed like everyone in the main revolution was like 110% for just murdering everyone, so that's why I'm so confused.
Change. That's what the people need. But sometimes I feel all I have to offer them is blood and fire. The things they done to me, I can't forget them. I was Columbia's victim. And victimhood begets shame. Oh, what element of human experience is more corrosive than shame? I'm...
Oh! Interesting. So she didn't want to go on the huge rampage, but her people were stuck on it.
Yeah.
And since,
I'm sleeping in Fink's bed tonight.
Oh, wait, hang on. Alright, play this.
Yeah, there's a war coming. You can smell it in the air. Fear, hatred, people dying every day. But how many more will suffer if we rise up? Violence begets violence, I know this. I've seen this. A rational mind argues for a peaceful solution to find a common ground, but what common ground is there to find for a father who watches his child bleed out in the street? How do you deny him his vengeance? I know that fire that burns deep inside. I know it all too well. And when the time comes, will I be able to stay the hand?
Interesting. Very interesting. Alright, yeah. That's another thing I've noticed. In the 1999 mode in the other game, death was always imminent. In this game, not so much. I mean, yeah, there's still fear. There's still, you know, like, oh no, I don't want to, you know, get murdered. But at the same time, I'm very calm. Oh, I was caught on that. I was like, why am I like, what's going on? Speaking of which, am I actually recording? Let's see, that's recording, and that's recording, alright. It's like, hang on. Where is this thing that just like randomly jolts where it's like, a minute! Oh wait, I'm actually spinning. That's convenient. Now I just stood on top of this. And so I need to... Oh, I can't. Oh, I get it, they're forcing me.
A giant clock.
Sort of.
What?
Looks like the mechanism unlocks certain activities when Fink gives his blessing.
So what? We're stuck waiting for the cuckoo to go off?
No,
hear that noise.
There's a slot for some kind of key for manual winding. We just gotta find that.
Okay.
Sure seems like a lot of work to lock down a few doors.
Well, if there's one thing Fink loves, it's a lot of work.
Oh, hey, look, there it is. Perfect. He also is a sucker for overcomplicated technology. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm a sucker for overcomplicated clockwork. Huh. Interesting.
Our current state of being, or lack thereof, has left my brother unfulfilled. The biological urge to leave one's mark is strong. And it is not an impossibility. We could instantiate ourselves back in Columbia. Return to an old life for the possibility of creating new. But we died in that world. Returning would mean giving up part of us. Ourselves. We'd become flesh and all that it is heir to. The mysteries of the universe would become once again mysteries.
We've got the clock.
So she went through the same struggle that I'm going, that I went, that I am currently. That's like that I'm coming, going. Okay. So, let's check out prayer. I was gonna leave that here so someone can lock me in when the time comes. It's like, why would someone want to lock you in, though? Absinthe. This area is also quite dusty. Musty. Oh, the candles are unlit. Let's see. Untold rewards await the faithful in eternity. What's this? Smoke cigarettes. So apparently Fink didn't care. Let's see the sword. Something you old shyster sure to impress the rubes. You give us sales, which I'll provide the snake oil. The able prophet's untold prophet. Nah! See what he did there. There's an able prophet, untold prophet. So is there anything to actually like in here, like a voxophone? Or is this just something I'm supposed to look at and go, dude? How come you didn't graffiti this one, you jerk? Sheesh. Nah, I don't think there's an actual reason down there other than, like, a crap ton of absinthe, which he apparently loves and throws everywhere for some reason. La la la. Leisure! I bet there's something cool in here, too. If this was real life, I'd be going straight to the lab. Like, I wouldn't explore anything. Cost evaluation, why injectable? Drinkable plastics require 10 times the atom with other injectables. The injectables are the clear economic choice. Repackaging will result in significant atom use there. 10 times the atom requires. No. Oh, I get it. I got drunk. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. Complete accident.
Sea slugs. Goddamn sea slugs. Could that Oriental have come up with a more inconvenient fuel for his plasmids? If there is a god, and I've seen more evidence to the contrary than in support, you'd think he'd have put Adam into the belly of a nice little seagull or crow. The cost of all these underwater expeditions are murdering my margins.
I like that I was like, sea slugs? Really? Why sea slugs?
As to the matter of religion, let me place myself in the camp of the agnostic. I pretend to understand the mysteries of the infinite no more than you, Comstock, or anyone else for that matter. But for the sake of argument, let's say this is all one unhappy accident, and we're all alone in our toils. Then who would Comstock use to control and shame us with rules that apply only to those without a penny in their pocket? If there were no God, you could rest assured the first deed done by the first rich man would be inventing him.
These are some really freaky paintings. Who took the time to make this junk? Yeah, rich men make God, obviously. Yeah, totally. We are going a bit long. Oh, because I just
accidentally. Good.
There we go. Find things lab.
Idiot's lock of hair.
Yeah, I don't like having long episodes. Like, Skyrim kind of broke me of that. So, on the next episode, hopefully we're going to find that lock of hair and then go back, set the thing up, make a balloon, raise it up, cause the destruction of Rapture, since, hey, Columbia's being destroyed, might as well make everyone that way. So, thanks for watching, I hope to see you then. I'm like, holy crap, there's this robot in my room! Not really suspicious, Emerald. Emerald, what's going on? Emerald? This is like Emerald! Alright. I'm also noticing.